Good evening. Good evening. Is this on? Yes. Okay, good. I'm Dr. David Tedford. I am the orchestra director here at Bloomsburg University. I'd like to thank you for coming this evening to our spring concert. We have a really great concert for you this evening. Some new music, some very special music by some very close to the music department student, former students. We have some classical music. But first off, it's not in the program, but we would like to play the national anthem to the Ukraine. We recognize all of the turmoil that's happening. I'm gonna step back a little bit. All the turmoil that's happening right now in Eastern Europe, and we would just like to show our solidarity to Ukraine. So if you would like to rise in honor of that, I invite you to do so. So our first piece of the concert is written by a former Bloomsburg University student, Nick McWilliams. He graduated in May of 2021, and I met him 6 years ago, I think it was, and he came in as one of a very vibrant student. He was very enthusiastic about music, and he would come into my office every now and then, and just be like, Dr. Tedford, do you know Beethoven's Third Symphony? I'm like, yes, I know Beethoven's Third Symphony. Dr. Tedford, do you know Dvorak's Seventh Symphony? I was like, yes, I know Dvorak's Seventh Symphony. Dr. Tedford, do you know Bach? I'm like, yes, I know these people, Nick. And so we really developed a rapport, and it was just a lot of fun. And then he, I think it was around his sophomore, junior year, he started writing music. And he wrote a couple of things here and there, and he'd be like, Dr. Tedford, can you listen to this? I was like, absolutely I can. And I was like, this is really nice. This is really cool. I want you to continue working on it. And he would kind of get lost in his studies, which is great, because you're supposed to do that as a student. Study first. And then eventually, he went off and did his student teaching, and he got kind of, I don't want to say sidetracked, focused on student teaching and being a professional, which is great. And then all of a sudden, it was this past summer, he sent me a piece of music. He said, Dr. Tedford, what do you think? And I listened to it. I listened to it again. And I was like, Nick, this is really good. I'd like to perform it this year. And he's like, really? I was like, absolutely I would. So this is the world premiere and Nick McWilliams' debut as an orchestral composer. I gave him kind of a hard time on the title, Epic Overture. I'll reserve judgment for that for you guys. You can tell him whether you like the title or not. So anyway, this is Nick McWilliams' Epic Overture. Every year, I try to take on a student conductor who is either a music education student who is getting prepared to go out to their student teaching, or someone who is interested in studying, perhaps conducting as a master's degree level. This year, I've taken on junior Jack Barshinger, who is a music education student, and he also plays trumpet. And so he will be conducting this next piece, Ancient Echoes of Time. And so I would like to welcome Jack Barshinger to the stage. This next piece is for strings alone. It's called Introduction and Allegro by Kevin Scott. He is a New York-based composer, and he is one of my beliefs and one of my focuses since becoming a collegiate orchestra director is to incorporate new music by living composers. One of the stereotypes, I guess you could say, is that orchestras only play music by a bunch of dead white old guys. And I'm trying to break that mold, and a lot of us are as well. So this is one of the composers that I found just by randomly Googling new music, new composers, and I came across this piece and I kind of fell in love with it. I thought it was really nice. It's a little different than the rest of the music that we'll be playing tonight. It's very polyphonic, meaning there'll be a lot of different things going on. It's gonna sound a little bit different, maybe a little harder to follow along. But before we do, I wanna play the first four notes of the piece, which he builds upon this whole four-note motif that kind of weaves its way around and through the entire piece of music. So the first four notes. So it's D, F, G, and A, and he kind of weaves those things through, those four notes through the entire piece. And so if you can, try to follow along and hear how he manipulates and adapts and evolves that whole four-note piece into a 9-minute composition. So introduction and allegro.
Thank you.
would be remiss, though, to not include some of the standard repertoire. And Schubert's Third Symphony is semi-standard. Schubert is very standard. He wrote an unfinished symphony that is very popular. It's been used in the Smurfs, if you remember the Smurfs cartoon show. It was the theme for the bad guy. I can't remember his name off the top of my head. And he wrote a magnificent Ninth Symphony. He wrote numerous art songs, which are about love, loss, love, again, lots of love. And he also wrote, if he wrote 8 symphonies, that means he had to write a third symphony. And so this third symphony we'll be performing to you tonight as our final piece is made up of 4 movements. And it was written when he was 18 years old. I don't know about you, but when I was 18, I was not writing 25-minute long pieces of music. So, you'll hear a lot of early Beethoven-esque motifs, a little bit of Mozart, a little bit of Haydn. He was born in 1797, died in 1828, so he did not live a very long life, but he was very prolific. So again, 4 movements, and feel free to applaud in between if you feel so inclined. If not, we will not be offended. So again, I thank you again for coming. We hope you have a great end of the semester, students. And for those of you, we hope to see you next year for our 50th year as the Bloomsburg University Community Orchestra. So again, thank you again for coming tonight. And we hope you enjoy Schubert's Third Symphony.